Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do some Christmas baubles. Not bubbles, baubles.
Thank God, no more bubbles.
Oh yeah, we'll still do bubbles sometimes. Oh, we've got to at some point. We can even do a bauble with bubbles on. Maybe not in this video, but in another one. It is Christmas after all. I've already applied a nail extension on the lovely Vanessa. What we're going to do now is we're going to paint the background with Snow White. You don't have to do white, you could do whatever you want, but I just want this to really stand out. Popping that in the lamp, we're going to do two coats of that. You need two coats, don't you, in this weather? Right, so we're going to do these baubles. We're going to do a thingy-me-bob bauble and a thingy-me-bob. We're going to do two different types of baubles. We're going to do baubles that have microbeads inside. How exciting. And we're also going to do, we've not had this one before, so they've sent us, no nails have sent us this colour, which is called Mulled Wine. Perfect. Perfect. We're going to use a cat's eye to create a bauble. I think that's going to look like amazing. Right, so let's take a little bit of this, and we need a little bit of black as well. Always looks better over a black layer. So we're going to take the black and make a little circle bauble. Even painted in a little hook. Now we are. Pop that in the lamp. And then we're going to take the cat's eye. Mulled Wine. It's a lovely colour. And we're going to paint that directly over the top of our little bauble. And I'm not too fussed that we don't go right to the edge. So we've got like a very tiny gap. Tiny black rim. That'll be a sort of create a shadow. So we're going to hold the magic eye over the top and pop that in the lamp
like magic.
Just like magic. Look at that. That's cool. Now we're going to do the other bauble. For this one, we're going to use the microbeads and they're going to go everywhere. We're actually going to use the builder in a bottle for this. So you're going to take a little dollop of the builder in the bottle gel. Told you, look everywhere already. I'm going to pop a bit of gel on the end of my dotting tool and go in to the balls. Those microbeads, pop them in there. Same with the blue. So they just stick to that bit of gel that we've put on. Mix them together, and then we're also going to add a little bit of silver glitter. Touch that, mix that in. I just want a few more of the greeny, turquoisey ones. I'm just going to take the corner of that buffer and just abrase that a little bit. Just so this really sticks on. Pick up a dollop of the mixture. Just go a little bit more. And turn it upside down. And then go into the lamp the normal way around. Yeah, try to get your thumb flat. Is it gone? Yes!
As I put it in, it slid to the left a little.
Right, turn it over, let me see. Put it in that, straight in that. Oh my god. Oh god, that was a bit stressful.
I took it out.
I know, you did good. Because at least it didn't go.
Because before I did, this the hand went in. It just...
If you're doing this in the salon, right, or on yourself, do it on your fingers, not your thumb. Because when the thumb goes in, it's on its side and it just wants to go. It wants to have like a little sleep. And you want it to be like a dome. So that's the problem we're having. Now we're going to take some mega gloss. Mega gloss is a little bit thicker. So we can actually just go over this and dome it a little bit more. Pop me that in the lamp. And then we're also going to use some builder gel on the cat's eye. I'm going to wipe over the builder gel because there was a bit of fluff on it, wasn't there? And we're going to put a little bit of the mega gloss over the top, which is thicker than the normal top coat. It's going to help with this sort of dome effect that we are doing. Let's get my little brush. And I'm just going to go around the edge. Pop me that in the lamp. I'm going to do a little loop here. Or a little hanger. I might even put a stone there, to be honest. Oh, I'm tempted to put a stone there. We'll cure that anyway, but you know.
Why aren't you tempted to put a stone?
Bit of a stone. I am going to put some stripes. Not stripes. Don't know where I've had stripes from. I'm going to paint a little snowflake onto it. Oh, shall I do a star? Star of David. I'll do a star. I'm going to do a star.
Don't have
a snowflake. Yeah, we'll do a star. What we're going to do on this dome, you're going to paint a star. And I'm going to sprinkle some white acrylic powder over the top of my little star. You can use clear as well, I just wanted it to be like extra white. Pop me that in the lamp. Let's give it a dust. Look at that, that's cute. Now, I know these look like they're just hovering there. We're going to connect them to a bit of a tree. So we're going to use two colours, which are bottled green and cyanide. So we're just going to do, these need to be quite sort of like, not neat basically, just like little flicky kind of lines. You don't want to start doing like perfect lines, it looks less realistic. Then we're going to take that darker colour, which is bottle green. We're not going to cure this while it's wet, we're going to pull through as well. So you get different tones of green as they merge together. Put them out on the lamp, so I've just mixed a slightly lighter green, just added a little bit of white, I'm just going to do some random little strokes. Pop me out on the lamp, and I've got some of the silver, and this is called Tarnished Silver from the Platinum Collection. Of the Urban Graffiti, we're going to do some little dots, as if they're like little bits of other decoration, and I've also got the gold, fill that in with gold there, and I'm going to fill this one with silver. Pop me that in the lamp, then I'm going to top coat. We're going to go around the edges of the balls, and what that'll do, it'll help to keep the balls on. So it kind of seals those edges, and it's going to seal in the artwork that we've done with the tree. That in the lamp. So let's add some cuticle oil. I like how you can really see the cat's eye and the on this one. Now we put the dome, it's sort of like magnified it, hasn't it? You can see through this one, like a glass bauble. Beads in. Very nice. So there you go, guys, a nice Christmas nail. Have you got all your presents?
Have you got any presents?
Got a few.
I have got
only a little few though.
Do you even do it?
No.
Hayley
does. She enjoys it.
Well, she can do mine as well, sure. Well, there you are. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget, everything that I've used today will be listed below, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we have an aeroplane flying overhead. I can watch it. Oh, I like that. That's so cool. Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches.